Yeah, well, it was 2019, early on, and or maybe late 2018, I can't remember, but it was, yeah, I got an audition for very similarly, very secretive. They didn't tell me what it was. I had no idea, but you know, you go in and you do your best, and then you completely forget about it because a lot of times with auditions, you don't get the job, so you just move on with your life. And then a few weeks, it was very soon after, they said, "Hey, we want you back for another try." And so I came back, and then they said, "You got the job." And I thought, great. And that's when I heard that it was for Blizzard. And I am kind of I'm a gamer, but not a major, massive gamer full-time all the time. But I've played video games since I was a little kid. And I knew Blizzard, but I knew them from the 90s from games like Lost Vikings, Blackthorn, and Rock 'n' Roll Racing on the SNES. And all the new ones, wasn't aware that the company was associated with World of Warcraft and Overwatch. But I've obviously heard of Overwatch. I usually work in animation. That's my main career. It still is. I love the cinematics from Blizzard because they're so rich and so highly, you know, the bar on quality is set very high. It's beautiful execution. And they look like these Disney-esque Pixar quality shorts. So I've seen those online and I thought, wow, these guys, this is amazing. It's beautiful stuff. Then when I heard it was that game, I thought, ooh, I'm very, very lucky indeed to be able to be a part of this. So I was amazed, but I didn't really know what it was until probably a few weeks or maybe even a few days before they asked me to go in and do the actual recordings. And I came in and I saw the character and I thought, oh, wow, this is a beast. That's a tank, isn't it? So I thought, oh, I love this guy. So I really, really got into it. And then to learn also that the character was quite complex and disjointed, and there was a lot of duality there, and that it was actually a dark, you know, meaty part, I thought was fantastic. So yeah, very, very lucky and happy to be part of it. To get back to that story bit, what I love that what they do is that they give you lots of lore for these characters and lots of history and background for these characters to really make you want to know more about them. But then they only give you little bits and you want to know more. And I think that's what it's this balancing act. They give you enough so that you're really interested, but not enough, you know, you want to keep coming back to it. You want to know more about these characters. And I think that they are also left slightly vague enough so that everyone can kind of project their own imagination onto them. And I think that's very clever. And I think that's why, you know, a lot of these characters resonate with so many people. And I think it's a wonderful game. And of course, the community is just, it's so awesome to see people come together and play online, and just the love for it. Still, after all these years, it's just incredible.